After 40 on Hockey Night in Canada.
How can a guy that's 235 have such a problem with a guy that's 175? It's the size of their hearts, boys. Let him into the box. Watch the lawsuit, Ty. Watch the lawsuit.
You know, a lot of people in Canada say that was the best hockey they've ever seen. And I'm one of them.
You have to play 40 games during the season or one during the finals to get your name on the cup. Surely to God, they'll put this guy down. Don't quit, Raymond.
You love the game, and we love to watch them play. Well, Harry Neal, 20 years you did the Stanley Cup with Bob Cole together. Sensational, your wit, your analysis, Harry. And I was thinking, you know, when you win the Foster Hewitt Memorial Award and go into the Hockey Hall of Fame, you had a lot of time to reflect, and you had a chance to make a speech that would combine your playing, your coaching, and your broadcasting day. So what was the highlight of your message that day?
Well, I had so many people to thank, and what I was trying to get through to the audience that I thought about for weeks before the actual presentation was that it's really a team award. They give it to one person, but when I got thinking about how did I ever win this, I got thinking about all the guys they worked with, all the people in the truck, the producers, the play-by-play people who were highly instrumental in me even being thought of, let alone win. And my message, I hope I made, was that they all had their fingerprints on it, and I happen to be the lucky guy that's accepting it on their behalf.
Lovely.
You know, I just remember, my first game at Hockey Night was in October of 2003, and it was Montreal at Ottawa, and we were staying at the Brook Street Hotel in there. We're going to the morning skate, and there's a shuttle, and I'm nervous. Like, I don't know Harry. I don't really know Bob that well. And I'm really trying not to do anything stupid.
Too late.
So
it was in mid-afternoon, right?
We come down to the car, and Harry's sitting in the back seat. Bob's not there yet. And Harry says, Elliot, why don't you sit in the front? Bob and I like to sit in the back and talk.
That's a setup.
I say, sure. Like, I'll go wherever you want. And he goes, yeah, Bob and I like to sit in the back. So I sit in the front, and 2 minutes later, Bob comes walking out of the hotel. He stops when he looks at the car. He rips the front door open, and he says, kid, I sit in the front here. And all I can hear is you cackling in the back seat laughing. Yeah. Thanks for the introduction.
Well, I knew you'd fall for it.
You and Bob, I mean, such chemistry, such a run. Thought about Bob.
Oh, absolutely. The three play-by-play guys that I did the most games with, Bob, Jenneret, and Joe Bowen. But I used to just admire the intensity that Bob Cole came to the game with, and I thought, geez, you know, if he'd played for me, we'd have won more games, and maybe I'd have kept the coaching job a while. And and his theory was, and I like this, where the play-by-play guy talks when the game's on, and the color guy talks when the game's off. And if you ever talked when the game was on, you got this from Bob. That was his signal to stop. So I quickly named it after the Heisman Trophy Award, and after the games, people would say, how many Heismans tonight, Harry? But he was brilliant to work with.
Yeah. Going back to your coaching, when you're in Vancouver, one of the reporters comes up to you and says, you know what? One of the veteran players told me that they don't like your practices. Your response?
That's fair, because I don't like their games.
Just that simple, huh?
Well, it was a little more complicated.
Right. What about the tradition that you had with the late Pat Burns during the playoff run with the Leafs and the Red Wings during that series?
Yeah, one night in Detroit, we're staying in Detroit, and it might have been games one or two of the round, and I ran into Pat in the lobby. He says, what are you doing? I said, I'm not doing it. He says, well, come on up. We'll have a couple of drinks in my room. And so we did, and we had a couple, might be an understatement, and they won the next night. So right after the game, when I'm telling Burnsy, hey, nice win. Well, don't forget, my room the night before the game. And the series went seven games. I thought, I'm going to have to go to rehab if this keeps going.
I remember Pat Burns saying in the next morning, he said, my head feels like a chewed caramel. Boy, that was a great
time. One of my favorites, Pat Burns.
You know, Harry, you worked hard at it. One of the things I remember, you mentioned Cole's intensity, but you were a teacher, so obviously you had to prep a class. And you used to rifle through books looking for lines, whether they be inspirational quotes or quips. The work that went into doing what you did.
Well, it didn't take me very long when I first started that you just can't go to the game without preparing something. I know you're trying to look at the stats of the players. But I always thought that hockey's such a great game, And it isn't like broadcasting a nuclear physics reaction. It's supposed to be fun to watch, fun to play, and I thought, well, should be fun to broadcast too. So I'd like to throw in a couple of stories or lines that I would like to tell you, but I'd have to cross my fingers that I thought up. So I did. I bought a lot of books, famous quotes, famous people and what they said under circumstances, and I've got a list. I've still got it at home, and some of them I've used again, thinking that most of the people that heard me when I first started aren't alive anymore. But that was something I took pride in.
Obviously, we're tight for time with the third period's coming up in Montreal. So rather than run the clip, Mike Dodson, we'll run it later tonight. I make you a promise. It's one of my favorite things Harry Neal ever did was in the late 1980s, he had this idea to get us to the Olympic Games. And so he created a Christmas dream about the NHL being willing to send the players. And sure enough, it came true come 1998. Harry, thanks so much.
Well, I enjoyed my years with Hockey Night in Canada and working with guys like you and Grapes. And your fingerprints are on that trophy, too. Thanks.